What's up, brand builders? Stephen Hurahan here at BrandMasterAcademy.com. And in this video, you're going to learn how to scale your branding agency and find better clients so you can move beyond the hamster wheel that is freelancing and start to build an actual business that pays actual dividends. Now, if you're new to the channel and you want to build brands that go beyond the logo and the visuals using strategy, psychology, and creative thinking, then you are in the right place. Hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. If you want to fast track your results, make sure you grab the Pro Brand Strategy Blueprint. It's a free download and the link is in the description. Now, most successful agencies don't start off successful. Most successful agencies, in fact, start off with a single person who has a few skills and they throw themselves into the market and they survive long enough to learn from all of the mistakes that they make until they become successful. Now, the common denominator for all successful agencies and all successful businesses, for that matter, are systems and processes, because it's only with systems and processes can you actually create an environment for growth and scale. So in this video, I want to give you 15 tips that you can take into your own business so you can grow and scale effectively. Tip number one, create a compelling offer. Now, if you have your prices up on your website, like a buffet menu, or if you have all of your products and services that are customized, as in every single one is different, then you're not making it easy on your customers and your visitors to make a decision. You need to make it as easy as possible for them to make a decision. And you do that by addressing the outcome that they want to achieve and the challenges that are standing in their way from achieving that. If you can show them that you can deliver that outcome while addressing those challenges, then that is a compelling offer that will drive them to take action. Tip number two, design a sales machine. Now, it's great that you have your compelling offer, but now you need to design a pathway that's going to lead to that compelling offer. So you have a website, but where is your traffic coming from? What are you doing to get traffic once they're there? How are you going to get their email address from them? What are you going to give them? What kind of value are you going to give them? Once you get that, what are you going to do with that? What emails are you going to send to lead them to that offer? And how are you going to present that offer? And the beauty about this is that you can automate most of this so it runs like a well-oiled machine. Tip number three, create efficient onboarding. Now, if you don't have your systems and your processes in place, certainly this is the way it was for me. Anyway, when I had a new client come on board, often it took me a long time to get going in terms of the actual work because I didn't have a process to take them through. There would be an initial call, there would be a follow-up email, there'd be a follow-up call, and there'd be this back and forth of me trying to gather the right information that I needed to get going on the project. And that can waste a lot of time. It's really, really inefficient. So you need to create an efficient onboarding process that takes them through step by step and takes them through an experience that gets you going really, really quickly. Tip number four, learn to say no. Now, this one was a big one for me. Again, I'm talking about the mistakes that I made here. I used to say yes to everything, and that was my motto. And I actually was pretty proud of that, that I would say yes to whatever was asked of me, and then I would figure out how to do it. Now, although that was beneficial for me in some ways, in terms of the experience that I got, in terms of the self-confidence I got of being able to throw myself into a difficult situation, in terms of my business, it didn't do me any favors at all because I was constantly looking for expertise outside of what I could do. So I was outsourcing different work and my processes were just all over the place. It took me so much time to get a project done. I always went over scope. I always got underpaid. So make sure you learn that skill, learning to say no, so you can actually specialize in what you want to be known for and you can focus on your systems. Tip number five, create a repeatable process. Now, if you have a process in place that you can just follow step by step, it removes all of the thinking that you would need to do if you didn't have a process like that. So if you were to approach every job as a customized job, as if every job was different, then jumping from one task to the next would take you so much more time. It would be so inefficient. And there is a lot to be said for efficiency when it comes to developing a business that actually works. So really take the time to map out the individual steps within your processes. So when it comes time to doing the job, you just hit each step one at a time. And it's so much more efficient when you approach your projects in that manner. Tip number six, optimize your processes. Now, just because you have processes in place, it doesn't mean they're set in stone and it doesn't mean they're perfect. And in fact, you should look at your processes as being imperfect. So you're always looking at ways to improve them. Now, one of the best ways that you can improve your processes is by listening to your clients, by listening to the questions that they have. Because if they are asking questions, then it means that you have left something out. It means that you haven't taken the time to be crystal clear on what it is that they're looking for. So take the time to not just listen to your clients, but to ask them questions as well about how you can improve and optimize those processes. Tip number seven, create splintered offers. Now, of course, you have your compelling offer, and this is usually your core offer and your main service. So it might be your brand strategy and your brand identity services, or it might also include a website. But typically, these can cost upwards of $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, and your prospect might not have an appetite for that kind of spend. And if you don't have a different offer, if you don't have a splintered offer to put in front of them, then essentially you're closing the door on their business. By creating splintered offers, it means you're addressing some of their smaller challenges and creating products and services around helping them with those smaller challenges. And that opens up a much bigger audience, a much broader audience of people who don't have the appetite for such a big commitment up front. So take the time to understand all of the smaller challenges that your audience has, create products or services around those smaller challenges, and create those splintered offers. Tip number eight, create multiple revenue streams. Now, this kind of goes hand in hand with the last tip as well. So for any given branding agency, they will have one or two revenue streams, which will be their core offer. But if you really think about it, if you really take the time to understand the individual challenges and the smaller challenges that your audience has, then you will be able to come up with ideas and products and services to be able to create multiple revenue streams. So an example of this might be a larger business that uses PowerPoint presentations. If you're able to provide them with pre-designed templates or tools that they can use on an ongoing basis, then you have a product there that can add to your revenue stream. So again, think about the individual challenges of your clients and create smaller offers around those challenges. Tip number nine, build case studies and testimonials. Now, we all know that social proof is a massive driver of sales, but many branding agencies, certainly a lot of freelancers, they don't take enough time to get those testimonials. Now, first of all, of course, you need to over-deliver on your service. You need to make sure that your clients walk away happy, but once they do, then it is so easy to follow up and get that testimonial and build out that case study and leverage that to get more clients. Tip number 10, create advocates. Now, again, for this tip, you need to make sure that you're over delivering on your service. You need to make sure that your clients are walking away happy. But once they are, advocates can be hugely impactful in terms of how much business they can bring in for you. Because at the end of the day, we listen to other people. If we have a friend that tells us that they have had an amazing experience, then, you know, we are likely to open our eyes and open our ears to the possibility of doing business with that brand. So if you're able to incentivize your happy clients to go out and speak highly of your brand, then you can create brand advocates and ultimately a sales team that can go out and do the work for you. Tip number 11, create a process library. Now, without a doubt, the biggest obstacle to scale for any business is the business owner believing that they have to do everything themselves. Now, every single business owner struggles with this at some point. I definitely struggle with it, and you probably do too. But if you take the time to grab a spreadsheet and map out every single task that is within your business, and for every task, map it out into three or four phases, and then go and shoot a video for every single phase within every single task, then you will have a library of processes for every single task within your business. That is absolutely genius. Imagine you had a library for every task within your business, then all of a sudden you don't need to do every task anymore. Tip number 12, replace yourself. Now, it's really important that you go through tip number 11 first in creating that process library. But once you have that, then you'll also have the confidence that you have the processes and the step-by-step actions that anybody would need to take coming in to help you within your business within those individual tasks. So take the time to work out what tasks you would like to let go of and gather a bunch of those tasks together, and then engage somebody that could take on those tasks. Now, you might do this on a contractor basis, or you might do this on a part-time or a full-time basis. Me personally, I believe that if you take on somebody part-time, it forces you to give them as many tasks as possible. But what this does for you within your business is it frees up that time that you would otherwise spend on those tasks. What can you do with that time? Get more leads, generate more sales, and grow and scale your business. Tip number 13, hire traits, not skills. Now, when you go to get help within your business, when you go and you put ads out there for somebody to come and help you within your business, you will get a lot of applicants. And chances are a lot of those applicants will look great on paper. They'll have great skills. But when you put them to the test, you will really find how great they are, because it's through those tests, it's through those tasks that you provide them that you will see their real traits. So what you want to look for here is you want to look for reliability. When somebody says that they're going to do something, that they actually do it. You want to look for strong work ethic, and you want to look for honesty. It's great that somebody has skills, but if they don't have the traits to take to the table, then they're not going to help your business. Now, the ace that you have up your sleeve here is that you have a video library of all of your processes. So you don't need to worry too much about skills. You will show them what to do. You just need to worry about getting the right traits into your business. Tip number 14, find partners. Now, one of the earlier tips was about learning to say no. But if you say no to somebody, it means that you're saying no to business, and also means that you're turning somebody away. Now, you can navigate this by finding the right partners. If you find partners in areas that you're not going to serve, then not only can you show people the right direction and really help them out on their journey and kind of earn that reputation as somebody in the market trying to help people, you can also earn revenue through referral fees. So make sure you look at all of the tasks that you're not helping those prospects out with and see if you can tee up partnerships to generate an extra revenue stream. And tip number 15, search for discomfort. Now, if you're feeling that you've got everything under control, that your day-to-day tasks are easy peasy, lemon squeezy, well then chances are you're not putting yourself out there enough, because it's only when you feel discomfort are you actually growing. So go in search of some level of discomfort. Look at what needs to happen within your business. What area of your business needs to grow? Now, you might believe that analytics is too hard, or you might believe that sales funnels are too hard, but you need to throw yourself in there. You need to find that level of discomfort, because it's in the discomfort that you're actually growing. The more you grow personally, the better a leader you will be to grow and scale your business. Now, it took me a long time to get out of that freelance trap, and it wasn't until I realized that the time I was actually selling was more valuable than the money that I was earning for that time. And that's when I learned to say no, and that's when everything really started to change, because in saying no to those businesses, I had more time to work on my own business. I had more time to look inside and look at my processes, look at my systems, and improve the efficiency of what I was doing to free up more time so I could actually create an environment that I could grow and scale. Part of that growth and scale is increasing your revenue streams. And if you want to learn how to increase your branding revenue streams, well, then this video will show you how. Until next time, brand like a master, and I'll see you in the next video.